Hello everyone, welcome to Joyful Creations. This is Jayashree this side. Since we are in the time of quarantine all across the world, I know it is difficult to buy supplies I shared in the previous two videos. Hence, today in the Mixed Media 101 series, I'm sharing with you all 5 ways on how to give background textures without using any pastes. But before we get started, please do subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with my upcoming videos in this series. To begin with, I'm using Ranger's craft tags as my base. You can use any heavyweight cardstock to make your own tags. The size of the tags I'm using here is 6¼ by 3¼ inch. For the first technique, I'm using a tracing paper. You can also use butter paper here as well. All I am doing is crumpling the paper and making a ball of it. This will add the textured lines we are going for. When we open it up, don't flatten the paper completely. More the lines, more beautiful the texture be. I'm using craft glue here to adhere this on my tag base. If you have a soft gel medium or Mod Podge, then go ahead and use that. You can spread the glue directly on the tag as well, or do it like I'm showing here. Now while I'm adhering the paper, I'm making sure I'm crumpling it more in some places for an added bumpy texture. Once adhered, I'm turning around the tag and cutting off the excess paper. You may add a couple of more layers of paper in some places if you want a heavy texture. You can also reuse this cut off paper on a different project to give texture. Moving on to the second texture, I'm using cheesecloth or a medical couch. They both work the same. I have pre-cut some cheesecloth and now I'm just stretching it to break the fibers. I'm again using the craft glue to adhere it, but you can use any gel medium or Mod Podge if you have. I'm repeating the process with medical couch as well. Another fun way of using these two is by adhering it as is without stretching on a piece of chipboard to give a faux stretched canvas effect. Once adhered, I am again turning the tag around and cutting off the excess threads hanging off the tag. In this time of quarantine, when we have limited craft supplies, it is important to get creative and think of new ways to make your projects. So here is the third way of adding texture with the help of packaging cardboard. I'm tearing off the first layer of it and getting onto the middle layer, which is the corrugated sheet. I'm tearing it in different sizes and shapes as I want to adhere it in different areas. Again, I'm adhering it with craft glue. Now make sure you don't flatten the corrugated design of the paper while adhering. Otherwise, you will lose all the texture that you want on the tag. You can randomly apply it in any place you want to give texture. Texture in the background. You can use this glue trick to give a wooden background effect as well. Moving on to the fourth way, I'm using a bubble wrap. This is available with almost every crafter, I'm sure. I'm first of all bursting some bubbles, not all of them. This is to again crumple it and flatten it a bit for adhering. Even though I adhered it with glue, it did not stick well and came off the paper once dried. So I would suggest you use hot glue or gel medium to adhere this in its place. Again, I'm turning around the tag and trimming off the excess bubble wrap. Last and final way I'm showing in this video is by using laces. You can use any type of lace for this purpose. You can even mix and match different designs of laces to make your own background. I'm using here a white cotton lace. I initially wanted to try on these three different laces, but using only one. So it completely depends on the different designs that you are using and which goes well with what. I had created a mixed media canvas in past using laces as background for texture. I have linked the tutorial in the top right corner, so do check that out. Again, you can use hot glue to adhere the laces or any craft glue like me. Backgrounds are ready for the next step of embellishment. If you want me to use any specific embellishment in the next video to create these tags, then do leave a comment below and let me know. If you're enjoying watching these videos in the Mixed Media 101 series, then please do share them and give this video a thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel before you go. Until next time, stay home, stay healthy, and keep crafting. Bye-bye.